Hey folks, Brian Shorey with the Walleye Guys. You know, it's early May. You know, a lot of people believe we're approaching that post spawn. Pretty much, you know, most all across the upper Midwest. Still a few, you know, fish spawning here or there. We're more or less hitting that post spawn transition time. A lot of people believe that fish, you know, the females, they don't eat for a couple weeks because they have a hard time catching fish after spawn. You know, and they move deep and they just kind of go lethargic. I'm not one of those guys. I believe those fish are feeding as soon as they're done spawning. They just burnt the most calories they're going to burn in the entire year. They just, you know, they breed and they eat. That's what fish do. So, you know, they just had their major workout for a couple weeks. They're exhausted. They're starving. Their bellies are empty. You know, they need to fill that up quick, and they're going to go shallow to find the bait. Okay, there are a lot of, maybe there's just not a lot of bait in the system at this time. You know, it's if it didn't get killed off during the winter. Nonetheless, some of that is going to be very deep, and those fish are going to be a little trickier to be able to find down there. But in the river system, you know, you're going to find a lot of them deep as they're hitting that channel and that, letting that current do the work for them and moving them down river. But I believe anytime they find an inside-outside bin with a nice big mud flat, you know, they can get up there and eat the bugs. I've already seen some of these walleye spit up, you know, mayfly larvae. You know, so there's plenty of that out there in the system for these things to feed on. But I don't believe they just kind of shut down. I've been catching post-spawn fish, pre-spawn fish, day after day after day. You know, right now I'm in 5 foot of water, and the key to this is you got to find these fish. And the only way you're really going to find these fish shallow is with your side scan. I'm a hummingbird freak. I love my hummingbirds. I have a hummingbird side scan. That thing is on all the time. We'll zoom in here and give you a shot. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 5 fish. I'm in 5 foot of water right now, and I can see 4 fish to my right, 1 to my left, looking out just 50 feet, right? Just a short little casting distance. It's in range. I don't need to look 200 feet out where I'm not going to get to them. Well, that's the best way you're going to find fish shallow. Come in there stealthy, put the trolling motor down. I'll even cruise through these areas. There's been a lot of boat traffic. Water's a little murky on days, but they're there. They're not scared of it. You know, they're not even getting scared of the motor, really. And every time I try to shoot this, I keep catching fish. So I guess I need to just not put a line in the water or catch fish. It helps me close their bell. You know, but these males are up here as well. They're up there shallow. You know, they're gonna be your first ones to show up, last ones to leave. So you may not be getting any big females because they're moving out of here. But just catching fish in general, those males are still shallow, and I've got plenty of nice females that are post-spawn up here in this 4 to 5 foot of water as well. But I wouldn't be fishing it without my side scan and being able to see these fish. I love to set mine on auto and let it bounce out and give me the best return possible instead of running at 100 or 200 feet and getting really small returns. It takes a little while to understand what you're looking at on the side scan, but I'm looking for long linear streaks, you know, bright white. That's, I know those are walleye. When I get a little clump of them, maybe even a shadow, and they're a little more short and round, I know I'm into the white bass. You know, it's one of my, you know, most important tools in the boat, because if I don't see fish, I'm not going to fish them. So hummingbird side scan is just, it's paramount. No matter what electronics you have, learn how to use them, become a master of those, and you're going to be a master angler on the water. I guarantee you, your electronics are key to putting more fish in your boat.